my polygons decline. The condensation of a diamond
Hello? Oh my god! Why did no one tell me my mic wasn't working for the last 15 minutes of my life? I'm gonna kill myself. I'm actually going to just go jump off the roof. I've been talking this entire fucking time with no idea my mic just wasn't working for no reason at all. God bless this fucking shitty ass mic that just doesn't work and I don't know why. Holy shit, I'm gonna kill somebody. You have no idea how much fucking stuff I talked about and now it's just gone to the ether. It literally, and it never has like a reason for not working either. It just doesn't work. Holy shit. I'm not gonna bother going back over everything. So we're here with Hong Kong versus Taiwan. We're getting into the bans. First ban for Hong Kong, double time number one, Anesthesia. That is the highest star rating double time pick banned out. Also the longest double time pick banned out. Taiwan gonna follow up with Nomad 4, that is number 39, that is the alt pick in the Nomad pool. Not an overly surprising ban, I don't think. Hong Kong looked really good on the alt pick last week. They double FC'd and Chaos Lits had one miss with really good accuracy as well. They won that by over a million points against Chile. Chile? Second man from Hong Kong is going to be hidden. Number one, Yorunaku Usagi Wayume Omiru, or AIM Hidden One. Somewhat older style with the CERN diff. Hidden AIM map. So it's very interesting. A DT, kind of straightforward DT ban, and a kind of straightforward hidden ban for Hong Kong. Meanwhile, Taiwan gonna get rid of the alt Nomad and we'll find out their second ban momentarily. They continue with the trend of last week. This could be like a DT4 ban from Taiwan if they want to go back to kind of the high BPM. Or DT3. But depends on what they're kind of scared of, as it were, for Taiwan. I just missed my mute button trying to mute before I sneezed. I'm so sorry. Yes, you can still ban same mod. You could ban same mod before, you can ban same mod now. Okay, so Taiwan gonna double ban no mod? I've never known anyone to have a rule that you couldn't ban Nomad twice. Usually if it's anything, it's like double mod pool ban, like it's a hidden Hard Rock DT. So I'm gonna guess this is gonna be either Blow-In or Resurrection spell. Anyone else getting tired of this song? Because I'm kind of getting tired of this song. And in other news, we have a match result. China 6-3 victorious over Team France. So they'll be our first entrance into the quarterfinals. Good job to them. man. Apparently Taiwan having trouble with their bands today. I don't know what's going on. This shouldn't take this long. Might have to start running some timers because this is getting a little ridiculous already. We're almost halfway in and we haven't even started the match yet. And it's going to be a hard rock band coming out for Taiwan. It is hard rock number 3 is their second band. That is Yosakura Fubuki, the past difficulty, which is a map that I literally don't know anything about. But that's going to be their band, and they are going to have now their pick to come. Right, we are finally done with our band phase. Apologize to people who thought this match might start and run on time, because apparently that's just not going to happen. Taiwan and Hong Kong both... Well, Hong Kong was late to the match by a bit because their captain didn't get the invite, and then Taiwan just taking a full timer and then some on their vans. And there is our first pick of this match. It's going to be DT number 2. That is Train by Malva, mapped by Rinsai. It is our AR 10.3 pick for this round. Just a minute 45 seconds long and 5.43 stars. So you know something wonky is coming when that happens. But it's a banger because everything in this pool is a banger. Also, don't mind me, I'm gonna probably blow my nose about 100 times over the course of this match. I don't know if I'm gonna have enough tissue. So, hope for the best on that one. The world if I didn't have allergies, man, I swear to God. And looks like we should be set to get going here on map number 1. We've got Chaos Lit, Star Styx, Muji, and Saku in for Hong Kong. We've got Shinonoriko, Willio214, Dazzlewind, and Neko Kamui in for Taiwan. We just need the players to get on the right teams and ready up, and we will be able to, at long last, get started with this match. About a half hour into things here, we're going to get our first map underway. And all the players are ready, so here we freaking go. All right, good God. So just a short little 10.3 here to get things started. Got some bursts to contend with. Not overly mechanically difficult in this intro. And nobody finding any early breaks. A little bit of an act difference, giving Taiwan a small lead, but not much to write home about there. First break is going to come from Saku on the side of Hong Kong, so that will be lead going over to Taiwan early on. Nakanitsuki following him up, though matched by Shinonoriko, so come a reset for those two. We have 3FC to 2 lead here for Taiwan. Castlets and Muji both looking very solid here. But that Triple FC from Taiwan, gonna keep them in the lead. Pretty short map here, as we said, so we're already halfway through. 300,000 point lead for Taiwan. There's gonna be a lot of points tied up in the last moments of a map like this, though. You always see those scores just shoot up as long as players keep their combo. This is just some more free combo for the players. Gonna help Taiwan build their lead even more. You need to find a break if Hong Kong wants to have a chance in this one, and, well, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say this map is too easy for this pool, because, yeah, this map is too easy for this pool. Gav, what are you doing, man? Like, there was nothing hard in that at all. What? Okay, well, Taiwan won. Unless that's a lot harder than it looks, that map is way too easy to be in this pool. Because that was just nothing. Oh my god. The ref didn't put the MP link in the sheet, so it doesn't have a score. Oh. I guess if you are really bad at 10.3, I guess that map could be hard. But otherwise, that's like really, really easy. But it is a 1-0 lead for Taiwan here on their first pick. Hong Kong with their own first pick incoming. At Mr. Referee, if you put the MP link in the designated slot on your referee sheet, you will get the correct score for the match, because I'm a genius. I don't actually know if he's watching the stream, to be honest. Alright, first pick for Hong Kong is going to be Nomad 6. That is Rin Intaway, set 15, Evening Primrose, the In the Shade difficulty. Back by Gaspo. So, well, get ready for something a little weird. That's all I can say, because I don't know the map. It's probably... So we're gonna go into a little bit of a tech awkward type of pick here for our Nomad 6 for the first selection from Hong Kong. And we'll see if that's kind of the direction that they're gonna take with their picks this match, if they want to maybe opt into the less mechanical or reading and gimmicky based picks against Taiwan, who are a pretty strong mechanical team. We are set to go here for the second pick of the match. It's going to be Castlets, A21, Hello Tom Wall, and Saku against Shinonoriko, Dazzlewind, Spines Knight, and Neko Kamui. And half the players are playing a different map than the other half. Okay. This glitch has been happening a lot lately. I don't know why. There we go. Really, I don't know what causes that glitch, but it's been going on a lot lately. Last week it happened a whole bunch, and it's already happening now this week. Alright, Neko Kamui gonna miss in the very beginning on the early free combo. Kind of relatively short map. This one's only 2 minutes and 24 seconds. But awkward rhythms, as you can see. Kind of unusual aim patterns as well. Pretty getting tripped up as of yet. Some players dropping a bit of accuracy, as you see Spines Knight down at 94%, as well as Dazzlewind. Neko Kamui down 93%. But Hello Tom Wall, surprising break for Hong Kong. Gonna give Taiwan the combo advantage here. Helped them bring the score back, but Dazzlewind gonna find a break as well. So, trading that one on back is Taiwan. 3 FCs to 2, the lead for Hong Kong. Castle take 21, Saku on those FCs, as well as Shinonoriko and Spine Sight. About halfway through here already. Neko Kamui not too far behind in combo, but Dazzlewind pretty far back on with Hello Tom. Oh, and it's going to be a surprising break from Chaoslets. I'm going to miss him on that slider, perhaps. And A21 following him right up. That's a huge advantage opportunity for Taiwan here now. They'll be able to pull this lead back as long as they can keep their combo up. That's a lot of lost combo for Hong Kong. Still about a quarter of the map left to go, but the lead's going to flicker on over to the Taiwanese side. Will they be able to get an early break point here now? Hong Kong with just Saku's FC left alive. Meanwhile, Shinonoriko and Spines Knight with the FCs for Taiwan, as well as Neko Kamui with the big combo. That was very disastrous for Hong Kong, and I don't know that there's going to be much time left for them to pull any sort of comeback, because Noriko and Spines Knight show no signs of letting up on their FCs. Looks like Taiwan's going to be able to take this point. Hong Kong early pick not going to work out for them here. Castlets with another break right at the end, and that is going to be the point. Going on over to the Taiwan side, that is 2-0 with the early break point. A bit of a surprise there, to be sure. But Hong Kong really just did not perform the way they needed to on that pick. Castlets and A21 both finding a couple breaks. Saku did end up with the FC, but just was not going to matter. Really good job there from Saku, but Shinonoriko and Spines Knight well for themselves also. Neko Kamui finishing solid score too. All three of those players performing admirably. Next up, we are going to see double time number 3, the next pick here from Taiwan. Starting off with a couple of DT picks. This one's going to be Yellow Zebra's Melody, the Lunatic difficulty. 162 beats per minute, the fastest DT. One of the fastest, I believe the fastest map in this pool as well. You are not considering number 39 since it is an alt map. This is the fastest map in the pool. Air 9.67. 6 stars, 6.01 stars with doubling time modification. We are ready to go here. Map number 3. roster swaps once again. Minecraft 570, 821, Hello Tom Law and Saku for Hong Kong. Ninoriko Dazzlewind, XZCraft P, and Neko Kamui for Taiwan. And Taiwan looking to consolidate the break point. See if they could take an early 3-0 lead. That would be a bit of a surprise start to this match. In a matchup that was, I think, on paper favored toward Hong Kong, but Taiwan on those first two picks performing really well to take that early lead. They need to win this one as well, though. They really need to consolidate the break point. Have a good, to be in a good spot going forward. So let's see if they can become victorious on another DT. Early lead for Hong Kong here as XZCraft P and Neko Kamui both find a couple of early breaks. A21 though, gonna break on the tricky little finger control. A couple back-to-back triples. Easy to mistap those. Gonna still be the lead for Hong Kong for now. You have triple FC against a double FC from Taiwan. Not a big lead though, about 100,000 points. Just a third of the way through the map. A lot of time left. Oh, it's going to be Dazzlewind finding a break for Taiwan. That's bad. He was one of the remaining FCs. Now they need a lot of luck to maintain any sort of chance at coming back in this one. Hong Kong with a huge lead. Minecraft 570, Hello Tom Law, and Saku all with the FCs. XZCraft P breaking as well. This one is not looking good for Taiwan. Noriko doing what he can alongside Neko Kamui, but the combo from Hong Kong is just way, way in the lead now. It's a 300k lead, and that one's going to grow fast here in favor of Hong Kong, excuse me. They would need a collapse of epic proportions from Hong Kong for Taiwan to have a chance in this map. I do think this is going to be the breakpoint coming right back. 400,000 points the lead. And continuing to grow 500,000 points even. A21 with another break, but that's the one that they can most afford to have break again. The other three players still holding on for Hong Kong just fine, and we're coming into the ending, so this one is going to be the breakpoint right back immediately. A little bit of a mispick here maybe from Taiwan. You know, they did ban the speed map last week, and Hong Kong typically looks good on these type of picks that require, you know, kind of the bursts and finger control stuff. And they're going to show that off here with the triple FC from Minecraft 570, Hello Tom Law, and Saku. 4 million point score from Hong Kong despite only a 590k from A21. That is a good piece of work there from the Hong Kong roster. The double FC did come in, or near double FC, from Shinoriko and Neko Kamui with just the early break, but Dazzlewind and XZCraft P not having as good of a time on that one. And Hong Kong does get the break point right back. It is 2-1 now for Taiwan, but the next pick for Hong Kong, they can tie it up 2-2 quite easily. We're gonna see what Hong Kong feels like picking here. You know, they picked the Nomad 6 as their first pick of this match, but then they immediately lost it and won a DT afterwards. So, you know, do they maybe pick one of the remaining, well, the remaining DT map? They've got DT4 left up. You know, alternatively, they'll have to switch it up to something completely different. Maybe the Air 8 CS5 free mod, but I think they probably feel that Taiwan's pretty strong on that. could be something like Evans. Or even Tonu Tage, actually. Nomad 5 could be an option here. I'm going to take a bit of time trying to pick this one. I also have Nomad 2 available if they feel like I'm kind of a stream map route. It is going to be free mod 3, so it is going to be Evans. He's extra. That's such a dumb name change. Handsome. It's just 4 air 9. Another short one. Minute 42 on this pick. 185 BPM. 5.83 stars Nomad, 6.25 stars with Hard Rock. Of course, we did see this in USC for the older set of this song. So you're familiar with the song, not necessarily familiar with the map. See a bunch of player changes, it looks like. The Star Sticks and Castlets in for Hong Kong. Poyoyo. 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 That's such a weird name to say. I miss Hakuna Desu. Rolled off the tongue much better. XCraft P. Taiwan's still in. The Hella Tom and A21 gonna come in for Hong Kong. So just leaves two slots now for Taiwan to fill. Junoriko and Minecraft 570. Coming in. Of course, don't know what Minecraft 570 is doing because he does not play for Taiwan. I don't know if he's switching out somebody from Hong Kong roster. He is gonna replace. Is he gonna replace Star Sticks? Nakano Itsuki. Just need the fourth now for Taiwan. Really getting away with the next pick. It's going to be Neko Kamui. Like, maybe, maybe not. Maybe Ethan TC going to come in for Taiwan. I don't know what's going on anymore. They've got Ethan TC, Poyoyo, Shinonoriko, and XZCraft P. I think that might be their roster. Nope. Maybe? What's going on here, guys? That's why we need timers in the world. People just taking a lot of time to try and figure out their rosters. Alright, well, we're ready. Hopefully they have mods set up that follow the rules. I guess we're just assuming they do. I should get an MP settings. I don't know, maybe he lobby refs. No, he doesn't. Whatever. So we hidden on Helitom Lull, Hard Rock on A21, hidden on Shinonoriko, hidden Hard Rock on XZCraft P, Minecraft 570 Castlets on Nomad. Ethan TC and Poyoyo are going to run hidden only, so a big overmod here from Taiwan. Let's see if that works for them or if it comes back to bite them a little bit. A little bit strange to me to see overmod like this on a CS4 AR9. You know, it's not like running extra hard rocks on an AR8 where you have people that just feel more comfortable with the higher AR. That being said, this is not an extremely difficult hard rock pick, especially if you're especially if you're a decent hidden player. Pretty straightforward aim. See here. XZCraft P gonna be the first to break for Team Taiwan, though. What was their hidden hard rock player? Followed up by Chaos Blitz, who does break possibly on the Buzz Slider. We'll see. I don't think that was Bancho, but I'm not positive. I Poyoyo gonna come in with a break for Taiwan. So 3-2, Hong Kong's favor. Awkward doubles gonna find Exycraft P and Ethan TC as their victims. This one's gonna be going to Hong Kong. Still the triple FC on the board from Minecraft 570, Helatom Law, and A21. Castlet's just with a one break for their team. Crazy what one miss can do to your score. Late miss from Minecraft 570 and Helatom Law, matched by Ethan TC. Castlet's and A21 get a break at the very end as well. Noriko looks like the only FC in this one, but Hong Kong was up by enough that they end up winning by over about 340,000 points. And that's going to tie things up 2-2. Breakpoint coming back, and Hong Kong winning their own pick as well. So from 2-2 down to 2-2 tied. We have a best of 7 on our hands here, starting with a pick from Taiwan. Very difficult ending of that pick, claiming several victims, but fortunately, Hong Kong established a big lead. Next pick to come from Taiwan. Started off with back-to-back DT picks. They go third. They go DT4. Now switch it up on their third pick of this match. Yakukakai Toshiro Tokuri would be the option. They wanted to go another DT. Only have other alternatives though if they don't want to stay in the DT pool. Still waiting on another Nomad pick maybe, or any Hidden or Hard Rock pick. You wonder if these teams just don't like the normal mod pools, Hidden and Hard Rock pools, or if there's some particular reason for ignoring them. I mean, there was one ban in each of those, but nothing too insane. Again, though, Taiwan running the timer, and it is going to be Hidden or Nomad 1 this time. Alright, well, get your Nomad 1 alerts out in chat here. It is Unhappy End World, Kotachi's Happiness. 6.4 stars, the highest star rating pick in this pool other than the tiebreaker. Very long. It's the longest map in the pool by 16 seconds, and almost 30 seconds other than Remod 2. 186 BPM, CS4 Air 9.5, mapped by Kotachi. So you know it is going to be a pretty straightforward Nomad type of pick. With maybe a couple streams here and there, bursts and such. Most people are fairly familiar with this map, whether from the TV size maps of it or from this version. Abby Suzawa Kurumi. Where is I'm underscore A underscore burger underscore fox? That is the question. I'm actually resident sleeping right now. It's only 2-2, and it's already been an hour, and there's another match starting. This is so sad. Everybody is ready, though, so we are going to be able to go into map 5 here. Bragbit 2, Castlet, Saku, Muji against Dazzlewind, Nekokamu, Shinonoriko, and Willy. 0-2-1-4 are the teams for Nomad 1. We're going to get underway here with this one. See if Hong Kong can get another break point. Taiwan can avoid losing 3 points in a row and win this on their own pick. Which I do rather like Kotachi maps for Nomad ones. These maps feel pretty okay. The aim patterns aren't like too just blatantly 1-2 jump-esque. No breaks in the intro, just Muji dropping a little bit of accuracy. So small lead for Taiwan. It's like 5k, so nothing to be too worried about, of course, as of yet. And into the first chorus we will go. Kind of your standard Nomad 1 affair where you really don't see any breaks until just some RNG moment in a big jump section or something like that. Or if somebody maybe misaims one of the burst streams. And it's going to be Saku with a random jump miss. Okay. Going to be lead to Taiwan. 4 FCs to 3. But Willio 2 and 4, as he said, you know, you can misaim those little bursts and he does just that. So it's going to even out the combo, but Muji's going to break immediately thereafter for Hong Kong. Taiwan's still going to have that advantage going into the second verse. .42,000 lead here for Taiwan, but that's going to grow. Free combo and an FC advantage. Not a good place to miss right before halfway. Willio 2 and 4 gonna miss again, but fortunately for Taiwan, that's a player already broke, of course. And that's always the player you want to miss. Yeah, if you could just say, hey, you miss everything, but we'll triple FC the rest, like, that's actually not the end of the world. We're gonna go into the second chorus here. See if any more misses are to come from any of these players in this section of the map. Just a consistency test, but there's a slider break from Dazzlewind. Muji gonna break again for Hong Kong. Again, not the end of the world, so it's gonna be relatively even now. Small combo lead for Hong Kong. They can make a comeback in this one now, especially if Taiwan finds any more breaks. Shinonoriko and Nekokamui have to hold on, especially with Willy breaking once again. Let's see what happens in this little bridge section of the song. And it's going to be Nekokamui finding a break on that stream. Nobody from Hong Kong missing. So the lead is going to flicker over to Hong Kong here shortly now. They have a pretty big advantage. Just one FC left on Taiwan on Shinonoriko. Meanwhile, Dragbit 2 and Castlet still FCing. Saku and Muji with solid combos backing them up. And now Taiwan having a lot of trouble. Nekokamui breaking once again. Dazzlewind and Willy both have very low combos. Shinonoriko doing again all that he can for the team. It's going to be a break from Saku, but it's going to trade with Nekokamui. Still advantage Hong Kong. Dragbit 2 Castlets, both with the FCs. This is their playground, really. Castlets, one of the most consistent AM players in this tournament on his good days. Just coming into this last Ki, Hong Kong should be able to bring this one on home for another break point, unless something really tragic happens at the end. Well, Castlets does break. He will not finish out the FC. I think we are in an okay spot here for Hong Kong. With the FC being matched between Dragbit 2 and Chinonoriko. That late miss from Caslitz is not going to have an effect on the outcome. It is going to be a victory here for Hong Kong. That is another break point, and they will take their first lead of the match, 3-2. Is 6.40 stars Nomad 1 being double F seed between Dragbit 2 and Chinonoriko. Caslitz with the one miss very late. Dazzlewind with just a slider break and 1-100 on top. Very unfortunate for Dazzlewind because that could have looked quite different. His slider break was in such a bad place. That's almost a million points there with a 1-100. Move the 50 for the slider break, and now all of a sudden Taiwan wins that pick by a couple hundred thousand points, actually. Bit of an unfortunate state of affairs there for Taiwan. Hong Kong taking advantage of it, though. And they will now have the opportunity to consolidate a break point of their own to try to take a 4-2 lead. The question is, what will be the next pick for Hong Kong? Do they go back to another free mod? Do they keep it in the Nomad pool? I don't think it's going to be probably a hidden. Could be a hard rock. We could see like Fuego or Yellowhead Joe, depending on how they feel about 6.5. I just don't have a good feel for what these teams really prefer in terms of picks. They can go kind of anywhere. And it's going to be Nomad 3 the pick, which is Blowin. So that is our CS5 older flow aim pick. Another long map, this one 3 minutes and 45 seconds long. That raises an interesting question. Has KTGster ever mapped anything that wasn't CS5? Like, everything KTGster is always CS5. I don't know that version of CS4 KTGster. Oh jeez, Blue Zenith exists. Okay, how about that wasn't a guest diff? KTGster diff of his own that was not CS5. Everybody ready for this one? It's gonna be A21 Castle. It's Minecraft 570 Hello Tom Lol for Hong Kong against Dazzlewind, Neko Kamui, Shinonoriko, and Spines Knight for Taiwan. Hong Kong has won 3 picks in a row. Taiwan trying to avoid making that 4, but this is Hong Kong's own pick. And it's a tricky kind of slider flow aim Nomad pick with small circles. And everybody's ready, so we should be able to get going here. Uh, thought the ref died there for a second, so I was just gonna start the map, but it was not called, it was not required. All right. See, is roughing two matches at once right now, because this one has taken so long. Netherlands versus Indonesia getting started. That's going to be... That was going to be the next match we were going to go to. Depends on how long this one takes. This song is so nice. It's just... That may be a little less so. Get the early break there from Hello Tom Wall. Minecraft 570 gonna find an early break too. I mean, we're not even out of the intro yet here. We've already seen two breaks from Hong Kong. Go into the real body of the map. Get some linear kind of flow aiming patterns, slider aim requirements. Things just intensify a bit. Nothing like super difficult in terms of mechanics, but that kind of linear flow aim stuff can be really easy to break on. Minecraft 570, Hello Tomo, both gonna break again here. This was Hong Kong's pick, and they've got two players that are really struggling on it in the early goings here. Linear aim is just, I don't know, I personally am somebody who has a lot of trouble with linear aim, so I empathize with players who are missing on this map. Meanwhile though, Castlet's still holding on to the SS, but Taiwan with the four-way. Still alive, almost halfway through. They're all feeling pretty strong on this one, it looks like. Was this what Taiwan needed? Break point here. Oh, Neko Kamui does miss on the last note of that pattern before the break at the middle of the song. 269,000 points. Nice. Gonna open the door just a little bit though. Taiwan still needs another break for Hong Kong to be able to come back in this. But one miss is a start. Especially with Minecraft and Hello Tom Wall trying to build those combos back up, and A21 and Castlet still holding on their FCs. Oh, but A21 is going to break, so... he'll be matched by Dazzlewind, though. Both teams dropping an FC. Now it's Noriko and Spine's Knight. Two FCs left for Taiwan. Castlet's the only FC left for Hong Kong. A21 missing once again. Neko Kamui with another break for Taiwan, though. Like, Taiwan is almost trying to keep this interesting, but... They've got a double FC, and that makes it very hard. Oh, not anymore, they don't. Dazzlewind and Shino Noriko breaking, as well as Neko Kamui. Is there going to be enough time is going to be the question. It's about 250,000 points to lead for Hong Kong, but they do have a pretty sizable combo advantage now. Spinestein with the FC, the only combo on the side of Taiwan. Meanwhile, Castlets with the FC, Hello Tom and Minecraft both with combo for Hong Kong. Is there time left to make a comeback? I just don't know if there is. I don't know if there's enough notes at the ending here. It's going to be tight, though. You can see Spine's at about 830,000 points. Gives you an idea of how many points are left at the end here. This is definitely comebackable for Hong Kong if all three players hold on to their combo, but it's going to be very desperately close in the last seconds. The score gap is coming down, but it's still 60,000 points. It's going to be to the last few notes here, and not enough. As Taiwan just managed to establish a big enough lead before they all kind of collapsed at the ending. Now, if Spine's Knight hadn't held on, I think Hong Kong could have done it, but he managed to keep the FC alive till the very end, and that was enough for Taiwan to maintain the advantage and tie things up now 3-3. Only by a margin of 44,000 points, but it was enough. They get a break point back to tie things up again. Hong Kong with some surprising struggles there. Castlets with the FC, but... Oh, Tom Wall, a couple breaks. Minecraft 570, a couple breaks. A21, slider break, I believe. Another miss as well. And it was just enough. Gonna be Nomad 2 here, the pick from Taiwan. Resurrection spell, Volcano, difficulty, mapped by Muya. This is the old Resurrection spell, all the way back in 2015. Famous for the GN Flashlight FC. CS5 AR10, average BPM of 180. This is an interesting pick here from Taiwan. I feel like Hong Kong has looked pretty good on Nomad 2s, but, you know, if you feel comfortable on it, then that's fine. Set up the teams here. See who's gonna break this deadlock at 3 apiece. I want to drop 3 points in a row, then finally to get another point back to tie it up. This is their pick here. We Hello Tom Wall Castle. It's Minecraft 570 and Nakano Itsuki taking on Neko Kamui XZ Craft P at Shinonoriko and Dazzle Wind. All players ready, so we're gonna get underway here. Map number 7 shortly. Everything gets a little more tense, you know, as you go on through a match and it stays this close, 3-3 in the best of 11. You know, 3-3, 4-4, maybe 5-5. It's just every pick becomes so meaningful. Go. About to get underway. Map number 7, Nomad 2, Resurrection Spell. Not on the line here. Hong Kong would love to be able to pick with a 4-3 advantage. Taiwan, though, want to find victory on their own pick for the first time in a little while. Stream as we go. It's kind of interesting, stacked four note on four note streams. Like, it's a consistent stream, but the way they map those into what look visually like quads with no spacing between them are very, very interesting stylistically. No breaks on the first streams. Everybody at 370 combo or thereabouts. Small accuracy lead for Taiwan, but not much to write home about. Dazzlewind and Hello Tom Wall gonna both break on the little aim section there. Combo reset for the teams, 3 FCs to 3. Into the little one-third stream. Neko Kamui gonna miss aim on the split stream. Break for Taiwan as we go back into the 1/4 streams. With the lead, gonna go over to Hong Kong here as they do have a notable combo advantage now with 3 FCs to just 2. Very unfortunate place to miss there, right in the middle for Neko Kamui. Hong Kong can hold on. They will get another break point here. Dazzlewind gonna find another break. XCraft P and Noriko doing what they can, but it's 3 FCs still for Hong Kong with Castlets, Nakano Itsuki, and Minecraft 570. Oh, but Minecraft 570 is gonna find a break. I don't know what kind of time there is left, but it's still pretty close. Oh, Neko Kamui breaks on nothing in the slow part. Oh, they just threw away the opportunity they had here to try and bring this back at the ending. Double FC versus double FC, not really much Taiwan can do now. It's gonna just come into the ending, and that's gonna be another point here for Hong Kong. Boy, I don't know what happened to Neko Kamui on the end there, but Hong Kong took full advantage. That's gonna be a 4-3 lead, another break point. These are a lot of break points, just back and forth. Yeah, so it's the only FC is Nakano Itsuki broke right on the last two notes. XCraft P and Shinonoriko both with the FCs, but Neko Kamui and Dazzlewind struggling a little bit. Again, now the lead for Hong Kong and their own pick to come. Somebody's got to win their own pick here eventually. Has to happen. 4-3 the score in favor of Hong Kong. So we're going to have another pick here from Hong Kong. Start to kind of narrow down the available picks in the pool. All we got left in the Nomad pool is Nomad 5, with Nomad 4 being banned. Nomads 1, 2, 3, and 6 being picked. We got Hidden 2, Hidden 3, Hard Rock 1 and 2, DT 4. Remods 1 and 2. Ever trickier business picking becomes, and it's gonna be Remod 1. So Applique, Apple Q difficulty map by Blizz. It's the shorter of the two remaining free mods here. Minute 57 seconds long, 224 BPM. It's a CS4 Air 9 free mod again. Similar stats as well, actually 5.76 Nomad, 6.14 Hard Rock. So what's the mods going to be here? What are the players going to be here? It looks like we do have both rosters in the lobby. It's Dragbit 2, Hello Tom Law, 821, Chaoslets. On the other side, Neko Kamui, XZ, Craft P, Shinonoriko, and Dazzlewind. Will we see another Taiwan over mod? It's going to be a couple changes here for Taiwan. Poyoyo coming in, as well as Spines Knight to replace Neko Kamui and Dazzlewind. Maybe not. Spines Knight going back out. Willio 214 is going to be the one it looks like playing. Again, another very important pick. Taiwan can tie it up at 4-4 heading into the last pick for each team. Alternatively, Hong Kong can have the opportunity, of a couple match points. This is huge. We're underway. Hidden Helitom, Lol, Hard Rock, A21, Nomad, Dragbit 2, and Castlets. More overmod here for Taiwan. Hidden on both Poyoyo and Shinonoriko, Hard Rock on Willio 214, and Hidden Hard Rock on XCraft P. Taiwan, interesting strategy in these free mods, overmodding them so heavily. Maybe this one will work out better for them? I don't know. I think this is a big risk to take, especially at this juncture of the match where it's 4-3 and you need this one to avoid falling down two match points. But if they have faith in their mod players, then that's all good, I suppose. I mean, you know Shinonoriko could play Hidden like it's no mod, but I don't know if it'll go as well for everyone else. Willio 2 and 4 and Dragbit 2 gonna find matching early breaks here. More damaging to Taiwan as that was a modded FC, but with the overmod, it's not going to be quite as bad. However, Shinonoriko having a bunch of trouble with those buzz sliders. So now, Taiwan already down to just two FCs on Poyoyo and on XZ Craft P. Hong Kong, meanwhile, triple FC still intact on Helitom, A21, and Chaos Lids. This is where the nomads may be coming in handy. Dragbit having some very big trouble on these bursts, but fortunately his team bailing him out, and Taiwan having a lot of trouble. Poyoyo breaking as well. Down to just one FC for Taiwan. This one's not looking good for them. And this one's just going to be Hong Kong running away with it, I think. They've got a triple FC still. With only one FC on the Taiwan side, a third of the map to go. I don't know if there's much that Taiwan can do. Oh my gosh. This one going really poorly for Taiwan. I'm surprised Hong Kong didn't pick this earlier, but maybe they expected Taiwan to be better on it than they are? I'm not sure. This overmod really not working out at all. You wonder if this would have been different if they'd gone two nomads instead of the extra Hidden and Hard Rock, but overbreaks from Hong Kong at the end, it's just not going to matter at all. A21 and Chaos Lids, double FCing. And that's going to be the point. Hong Kong team finally winning on its own pick, and it's when they most needed it. 5-3 goes the score. Match points now in their favor. 5-3 means that Taiwan's got to win the next two picks if they want to send this to a tiebreak. I really don't know about the overmod there on that pick. I think Taiwan may have overestimated their abilities on that pick. But who knows? Maybe it was just a map that they weren't very confident in no matter what, and they thought they'd throw a caution to the wind. Their own pick to come with match point down. They try to stay alive in the winner's bracket here. Yeah, XC Craft Hidden Hard Rock FC'd, but I just don't know that it was worth it. Didn't end up making a difference. So, if you're Taiwan now, I mean, you just got to pick whatever your best map out of the remaining options is. And I don't know what that map might be. I don't think it's Nomad 5. I don't think... I mean, it's maybe a hidden? I don't know if you'd like the AR-8 hidden, though. So it just leaves Lost Desire as the option. I don't think it's a Hard Rock. We do still have DT4. Yaku Kakai to Shiro Tokuri. I don't know if that's a DT that they really feel like opting into, though. I don't think they want to do the CS5 AR-8, and I don't think they want to do the CS4 AR-8 hidden. So it really narrows their options down to, like, Nomad 5, Hard Rock 1 or 2, hidden 2. Maybe DT4, but that's risky business. This is a very tough pick here if you're Taiwan. And it is going to be hidden too, so they are going to go the AR-8 hidden. Now, I can't say I'm overly surprised here. This is something that a few of the players on their team are very good at. But, boy, I don't know. Hong Kong's good at it too. Because Hong Kong's good at everything kind of gimmicky. It's a very long sort of map, though. 3 minutes and 47 seconds. Previous consistency picks have kind of gone the way of Hong Kong. If you look at things like Nomad 1, Nomad 3. These are really the only two longer maps we've played. Gonna wait on the teams to assemble in the lobby for what could be the last map of this match. Is in. Players are all ready, so we are going to get going here. It's going to be Saku, Minecraft 570, Hello Tom Wall 225, and Chaoslitz against PoYoYo, Dazzle Wind, Shina Noriko, and Ethan TC. Chaoslitz in for the AR-8 hidden. Alright. This is a relatively straightforward type of map. There's a few overlaps, but relatively comfy type of BPM and everything, so not the most difficult of AR-8 hidden. Did see the early break from Minecraft 570, though. PoYoYo gonna find a break for Taiwan. He's even on misses now. PoYoYo having a little bit of trouble here in the early goings, but Saku's gonna find a break as well for Hong Kong. Minecraft 570 has gotten his combo back up, just the early break. But it's a small lead here for Taiwan. They'll be able to bring the score gap back. It's going to stay very, very close, though. Very low accuracy for PoYoYo thanks to his troubles, so that's going to drag Taiwan just a little bit down. And there's a break from Dazzle Wind as well, trading with Minecraft 570. 2-2 on Helatom, Law, Caslitz versus Shino, Noriko, and Ethan. So this is going to come down to, oh, Shino, Noriko, maybe a little misread there. That was very strange. Unlike him to miss on that type of pattern. But that's going to be big because that means that Hong Kong now has the advantage back again, especially the double break from Taiwan. Oyo breaking again, Dazzle Wind dropping a whole bunch of ACK and then dropping again. Yeah, I don't know about this pick here for Taiwan, guys. I think this may have been a little bit of a misplay here. Caslitz and Helatom Law both just making an absolute affair of this in favor of Hong Kong. Oyo with yet another break. He and Dazzle Wind really are struggling on this one, unfortunately. Ethan, the only full combo left for Taiwan. Shino Noriko got a bit of combo, but not a lot. Hong Kong is just really going to run away with this one. And this is going to end the match. Ethan now breaking. I think Taiwan just felt that they didn't have any picks left at this point, unfortunately. I don't know that this was the best of the options. Maybe they just kind of coin flipped it a little bit. But I think this was the result of really not having anything left that they felt confident on. You get several breaks. Saku Caslitz, Dazzle Wind. But, you know, Taiwan did well for themselves, acquitted themselves quite well through the first, six maps of this match. It was 3-3, remember? But Hong Kong just too strong, too deep, too well-rounded. Have players for every type of map. It's very tricky to compete against that. This is going to be a hell of a score from Helatom Law 225 to close out this match. Working on a 1x100 FC, maybe 2x100 FC. That's going to do it. Hong Kong are going to be your victors by the score of 6-3. A very strong performance on those last few picks from the Hong Kong side. Helatom Law putting an exclamation mark on it with a 2x100 FC on the last map of the match. And a 780,000 point victory there for Hong Kong means that they will advance onward in the winner's bracket to the quarterfinals. They will face off against the winner of Sweden versus the United Kingdom. That match will take place tomorrow, so they will find out their opponent then. Taiwan going to drop on down to the loser's bracket. They will face the victor of Slovakia versus Japan, another match that will be taking place tomorrow. So neither of these teams going to know their opponent for quite some time. But I think Taiwan's going to be well placed to try to make a run through the loser's bracket. You know, they'll take on the winner of Slovakia versus Japan, then the winner of the Sweden-United Kingdom loser against Spain-Ukraine winner. I think Taiwan can beat all three of those teams, or all four of those teams, five of those teams, six of those teams. Yes, six of those teams would really be the way to do it. So, we'll see how things go for them, but I think they're a team that can make a run in the loser's bracket. Meanwhile, Hong Kong, I think their path to the semifinals is pretty clear, because I don't think they'll lose to either Sweden or United Kingdom on a quarterfinals pool, which will set up a date with Poland, Norway, or China. Hong Kong versus China semifinal. Boy, that's an intriguing one on paper, isn't it? That is a very interesting matchup to think about, Hong Kong versus China. Oh, there's no political implications there at all. But hopefully, I think they can leave that sort of thing out of it, because I imagine the players in an OSU match are not going to be taking that aspect of things into consideration when playing. That's going to do it for this match, though. With it already being about 15 minutes before the next match is going to start, we're actually going to hang on for a few minutes. We're going to just hold off on another match so we don't get a really big overlap. So that does mean we're going to miss Netherlands versus Indonesia, but it means we'll be able to get in all of Russia versus Brazil. So we're going to leave the stream up. We're going to go to a little interstitial here for about 20 minutes. We'll be back. At 16 UTC for Russia versus Brazil, starting at that point in time. We'll leave you guys with some music to hang out to. Some lo-fi hip-hop beats to study and relax to in between OSU matches. But that's a GG here to Hong Kong, moving on to the quarterfinals over Taiwan by the score of 6-3. And we'll be back in just a little bit for the next match here. Stick around. It is 4WC round of 16. We'll be returning for some more winner's bracket action in just a little bit.